Can't do this on my own. Someone watching close. Jumping, 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 j guys for a little pregame. All right, welcome back to Box Elder High School tonight. The Royals are in the house here, and Roy comes in with a record of 10-12 overall, 5-8 in region play. Box Elder 8-5 in region play, so just swap those numbers around, and 9-13 overall. So, you know, I think we're going to be in for a good ball game tonight. It is senior night. We're going to start a little bit early. To me,
this is a rival game when these two get together. Because my kids played, and it seemed like every time we played Roy, it was – so I expect a good game tonight.
Awesome. Got John back with me, a voice from the past that we used to have with us. Glad to have him here. So,
last game. That's fun to be here.
So, in the region, if you look at the region standings, Box Elder has a slight advantage there. Trying to go back. Box Elder won at Roy 59-56.
Right.
So, advantage Box Elder there as well. Box Elder's playing at home, that helps. So, we'll see. We'll get into some of the stats here. We're getting ready here in just a few minutes to introduce the seniors and the senior parents. Exciting night here. Always a good night here at senior night. And
oh yeah, I think that's one reason why I came, was to watch the seniors play tonight. And now I get to really watch them do it.
Now you do.
Right over the top of them.
That's right. Front row seat up in the bleachers. How's that?
Right on. I like it. I like it.
Well, they're later starting what they told me they was going to start. So here we go.
Our senior night for the Box Elder Boys basketball team. We would like to start off by honoring our seniors. All right, first up, we are going to honor Dax Sunco. Dax is the son of Nate and Aubrey Sunco. Dax plays a silver mission, and after he attended Weber State and played football. Dax's favorite basketball memory was going to North Carolina with the boys.
We just sent a cameraman to the other side. And
can they bring him back over here?
Next up, Jordan Mason. Jordan's the son of Tate and Josh Mason. His plans after high school are to serve a mission and eventually go to college. His favorite memory during this season was beating Bountiful. It's here for Jordan and his parents. All right, next up we have Derek Nesson. He's a son of Aiden and Wade Nesson. His plans are to serve a mission and as well go to college with Jordan Mason, most likely. His favorite basketball memory was going to North Carolina trip his junior year. Let's hear it for Derek and his parents. Next up, we have Big Max Isaacson. Max is the son of Big and Ginger Isaacson. His plans are to serve a mission for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints and go to college afterwards. His favorite memory is his first dunk in a game with Elijah's flashy behind the back pass. What a play. Let's hear it for Max and his parents.
I remember his sister playing for the girls.
Yep.
She
Next
was
up,
very
we have
good.
Trevor Wilkinson. Trevor's the son of Abby and Joel Wilkinson. His plans after high school are go to school at Utah State and get a business degree. His favorite memory was hitting 5 threes at Balfour and beating them on the road in overtime. Cheer for Trevor and his parents. There we go. Now picture. Next up we have Kaden Anderson. Kaden is the son of Jason and Shanna Anderson. Kaden plans to attend college after high school. His favorite memories are bus rides with his teammates. Let's hear it for Kaden and his parents. And last but not least, we have Elijah Kersey. He's the son of Casey Kersey and Cameron Kersey. His plans are to play basketball in college. His favorite memory is hanging out with the boys junior year on the North Carolina trip. Let's hear it for Elijah and his parents. Then one last hand for all these senior players and their parents. Let's hear it for them and their commitment. Parents, we thank you for your dedication, getting these kids to practice for years and years.
All right, pitcher time. You know, always exciting with the seniors. You wonder what you're going to do next year without them, and always seems to work out one way or another.
Yep, they'll do good. They struggle, but, you know, I remember earlier teams where the guys were bigger, and they just don't seem as big anymore. I don't know why, but they're this team's a hustler. I've watched them play a few games, and they hustle.
Yep.
They're a good hustling team.
All right.
Don't give up.
You know, we heard that Elijah Kersey's wanting to go play college basketball. He leads this team with over 20 points per game.
Wow.
You know, just under 2 3-pointers per game. If he's hot, he is hot.
Yeah.
Watch out. So.
Yeah, he gets in a rhythm, boy. Watch out for him.
He's followed up by the big man, Max Isaacson, with just under 14 points a game. And then Trevor Wilkinson, he's coming in with 8.5 points a game. And then from that point on, we need somebody else to step up in this game because, you know, if somebody gets in foul trouble, you know, whether it be Elijah or Max, that's trouble.
Yep.
You know, we got to have those two out and going. Looking at Roy, on the other hand, they've got their main scorer, Bronson Belknap, with 14.5 points a game. But the thing is, they're a lot more well-balanced. They're followed up by Colby, and I'm going to mess this name up, Frochter, maybe?
Frochter, that's what.
He has almost 13 points a game. And then they've got Dalen Pontius at just under 10 points a game, and Corbin Schaffenhauer at 9.5 points a game.
So they've got some shooters.
And Isaac Burnett at just under 6 points a game. So they got five players averaging over 5 points a game. That's pretty well rounded. That's, you know, Roy's got to stop Kersey and Isaacson, you know, mainly. You know, Box Elder, they got five players they got to defend and take care of.
Right. I'd like to see Isaacson have a good game. I've watched him a couple times, and he struggled, but not Isaacson. I mean, Jepson. See the big tall guy?
Yep.
Yeah, Jepson is one I'd like to see have a good game. Isaacson, to me, plays well. He hustles all the time. But if Jepson can have a pretty good game, I think Roy or Bachteller can win this fairly easy. I wouldn't say easy, but they might be able to win it.
Yeah.
Yep.
Bachteller has a slight advantage. I'd say, they got the better region record. They beat Roy at Roy, and they're playing at home.
Yep.
Therefore, I'm going to go advantage Bachteller, but I don't think it's going to be an easy game.
I really don't think it's going to be an easy game. But I think Jepson can really help him out this tonight. If he can have a good game, they'll be there. Got two of our refs back for this game.
Yeah. Well, the one's young. He can handle it.
Yeah. The middle one's been reffing for ever and ever and ever. The long-haired guy.
Yeah.
He's been reffing forever.
All right. We're about ready to get things started. We're going to have the national anthem coming up here in just a minute. I'm guessing the band's going to play it. They're acting like they're getting ready for that.
Still half a minute.
Basketball game tonight versus Roy High School. We would like to start our festivities off tonight with the national anthem. We'll wait for Roy to clear the court. All right, if you would all rise and face the flag tonight, the national anthem will be performed by the Boxing High School Pep Band. School Activities Association and support the statewide sportsmanship program Raise the Bar. We encourage you to cheer for your team but not against the competition. Please get rowdy, but do rowdy right. All right, we would like to welcome the starters for Roy High School now. Starting tonight, number one,
do you need this one?
Fonger. Number two, Gordon Schopenhauer. Number three, Bronson Belknap. Number 11, Dalen Pontius. And number 20, Daxton Warren. The Royals are coached by Ryan Hanna. Make some noise for the Godson of Bees. Starting line, a senior, number 10, Jordan Mason. And senior, number 3, Elijah Carson. a senior in the foul, Trevor Wilkinson. A senior number 20, Derek Nassau. And a senior number 35, Max Isaacson. Let's play some basketball.
All right, John, we are getting ready to rumble here.
Yep, here we're getting ready to go.
Isaacson jumping center against Proctor. And Isaacson's been fairly decent about controlling the tip this year.
Has he?
He'll tip it probably over here by this official.
Too close, he's coming that way. Yeah, he was so much taller than the other guy, though.
Inside to Nesson. He had it if he would have done it. Three ball right off the bat. That's good.
Trevor Wilkinson.
Wilkinson and Brigham Community Pharmacy supplied that one. The rebound, Isaacson. Wilkinson heading down there saying, I want the ball, get it to me. Nesson for three. No good. Kersey the rebound. He's
put
up and in.
Good shot by Isaacson.
Stop the play. Something's on the floor. Official got it.
Okay, here we go.
Excellent start here for the Bees tonight. Nesson with the foul.
Before that shot, charge to auxiliary player 20, Derek Nesson, his first.
Anderson will come in.
In for auxiliary number 4, Caden Anderson.
For Nesson.
Oh.
Kersey, I don't think he meant to do that, but rung the bell there pretty good of Daxon Warren, I think.
He did. I think something looks like he's pretty solid. You're into him, and it's going to hurt.
Yeah, I think pound for pound, Kersey's one of the strongest players we've got.
Oh, yeah.
Not just here, but all the way around.
Hi, how are you?
Roy to inbound. Leap and lean, no good. Isaacson almost the rebound. Ends up in the hands of Pontius. And Belknap with 2 points. And tough defense, Warren's putting on Kersey. Anderson inside, and Isaacson can't hold on to it.
Lost the ball.
Stop and pop, no good. Isaacson the rebound. Isaacson's going to be a key in this game there with the rebounds. He controls the paint. Kersey picks up the loose ball. Isaacson for three, count it. another Brigham Community Pharmacy three-pointer.
Three. That's a courtesy.
And again, another Isaacson rebound.
Jersey down.
Mason, three.
Himself. He's
from
got
the
it.
Corner. Let's just leave Brigham Community Pharmacy on the board. Box Elder with 3 3-pointers and Kersey a 2-pointer. And it's a timeout. We'll be right back.
Nucor is a great company. They care about their people. They care about the environment.
I've never been restricted to fall in a box. I've never been told that I can't do something.
I saw it as a great opportunity to develop a career.
You create your own destiny at Nucor.
We're building something bigger out here at Nucor. Come join us.
All right, welcome back. 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Box Elder out to a hot start.
I think they've only missed one shot at that. They're playing well.
Three ball, no good. Rebound goes to Pontius.
Oh, Wilkinson almost got there. Oh, yeah.
That's two quick ones on Kersey. And here comes Sumko. Unfortunately, both those fouls they could not have not called.
No, they had to call them both. Got cut up on both of them.
And a bump by Sumko.
That was a good bump. That was a good bump.
That's another one you don't want to
mess with.
He's a brick wall.
Yeah, he is. He is.
And Isaacson the rebound.
He'll take it right there. There's three.
Three again.
Wilkinson for three.
Brigham Community Pharmacy's having a night here tonight.
Wilkinson's playing some pretty good defense out there. Oh.
Inside, great pass into Pontius and gets the 2 points.
That was a good pass. Another one. Oh, close.
They're going to call a foul on Mason this time. And that's going to send him to the free throw line.
Well, they haven't got any fouls yet. In high school, they don't go to 7, it goes to 5.
And it resets every quarter.
Every quarter.
That's a new rule this year.
Okay. I didn't understand that.
Procter, the free throw. Buchanan comes in. Nesson comes back in. Mason will sit. Anderson sits. In and out, Isaacson the rebound. Isaacson averages about 10 rebounds a game, and he's got almost half of that already here.
And that's what they need him. They need him. Oh, they need Isaacson to score and to be out right out there.
They need to feed him down low because they can't stop him.
No, they can't.
And a block by Isaacson. And a block on the other end as well. And 2 points there by Frolcher.
Oh, come on, get it, hold it, grab it.
Nasson's got it, and he's fouled. This foul's going to be on Pontius. Case and Anderson coming in now to replace Sumko. Inside, oh, a tip.
That was a block. It was a good block.
I'd give that one to Nesson, I think, and the rebound.
Yeah, Nesson, yep.
A lot of trapping going on out there.
Timeout box over.
And timeout called. We'll take a quick one. We'll be right back.
The following was performed by everyday riders like you. Please try it home. Matt's a straight ripper.
I heard the turbo and I was just giggling under my helmet.
Look at that.
I look like a pro. Woo-hoo!
Dude, I love that thing.
Kent's Market is your hometown grocery store meeting your everyday needs, whether it's fresh produce, quality meats, or a made-from-scratch bakery. Their excellent customer service will meet your needs, even at their pharmacy. Kent's has stores located in Brigham City, Tremont, Roy, and Clearfield. Check us out on Facebook or on our website, www.kentsgrocery.com. Oh, and don't forget, every Friday, it's Fritter Friday. All fritters are 2 for $1. Kent's Market. Locally owned and operated.
All right, John, we mentioned the RPI is down. Box Elders won their last two games, and they've been riding the fence here on the RPI to see where they're going to sit going into the state tournament. Whether or not they get a home game or not, we will see.
This will help them if they can pull this one off tonight, though.
They started off when the RPI first came out down at number 28 out of the 30 teams in 5A.
Oh,
that was ended up in the hands of.
Oh, he needs to make.
He had hands all over him on that.
He did.
So foul is going to go against Schuffenhauer. I hope I'm saying these names right. I apologize. I'm not meaning to butcher them as bad as I am. So we got the crumble cookie free throw line for the first time tonight, and it is the right flavor for Max Isaacson.
He's a crumble cookie eater, huh?
Well, apparently he made that shot.
Oh. Good for him. You better make this one. There you go.
2 for 2 from the crumble cookie free throw line for Max Isaacson. Way downtown. Count it for Frolcher.
Frolcher.
Belknap knocks that one out of bounds. Box Elder ball. Kersey back in the game now. Last touch by Frolcher, and I think if you would have let it go, it would have been their ball.
Yeah.
Kersey.
Nice shot, Kersey.
Leap and lean for two. Nice turnaround shot by Schuffenauer. Swing it, Anderson, three ball, count it! Brigham Community Pharmacy again.
Jason Anderson, nice shot.
Defense there by Buchanan off from the foot of Frochter. So, three-point line has been hot for Box Elder. Anderson again misses, and that will end the first quarter. Box Elder 21, Roy 12. We'll be right back.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. My wife Lori and I have always felt that family is important, and when you have a family-owned funeral home, you get personal attention than you do than the big corporate funeral homes that are in the area. A lot of funeral homes will just say, here's your bag and thank you for letting us do your services, but we like to go one step further ahead.
John Filson,
Paul Winterton,
Stephanie Haley,
Adam with the Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
Our team is delivering the best care possible to patients that are suffering from osteoarthritis, degenerative joint disease, and also looking to optimize their sports performance.
I firmly believe that the body is designed to heal itself. So PRP, hyaluronic, those things are very safe and working with the body to heal.
Welcome to Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
All right, quarter number two coming up here. Box Elder in pretty good control that first quarter.
And they shot the ball well.
Yeah, I would not expect to keep to get five three-pointers in every quarter.
No.
In and out, Mason the rebound. Mason the floater on the way. Oh. Isaacson the rebound. Isaacson got to keep that ball up high.
He can't go. Oh, he misses.
And Isaacson's hurt. His ankle came down on a foot. Three ball from the corner by Warren. He's going to, Isaacson staying in, but he's gimping on it a little bit.
They really need him to make those if he can. I know it's tough, but.
Kersey misses. Easy shot there by Pontius. And stripped away by Belknap. Misses the layup on the other end, and Isaacson rebounding, and he's going. Offensive foul.
They're going to have to get Isaacson out of there, I think.
He's a little frustrated at the moment. So Box Elder takes a quick timeout. We'll take one, and we'll be right back.
Earning your degree doesn't have to be complex. USU Brigham City lets you stay close to home and save money. As an Aggie, you'll have access to a personalized education with student support from faculty mentors. Let us help you achieve your goals your way. On campus, online. This is your U State.
Hi, I'm Ryan from CoverUp. We offer embroidery and screen printing to help you promote your business. We can also help you with your church or school groups, family reunions, or any other occasion that might require a t-shirt. So come in and see us at 47 South Main in Brigham City or 115 West Main in Tremonton.
All right, here we go. Downtown, no good. Kersey, the rebound.
Kersey, box on the rebound.
Kersey takes it in. No good. Just a little out of control going through there.
Oh, wait, wait.
Travel call. But Box Elder yet to score here in the second quarter. And 5-0 for Roy here in the second. Box Elder's got to be strong with the ball. They got to get some things happening here that they haven't had going. Kersey, 15-footer, long. Schuffenauer, the rebound.
Oh, double. Ooh.
Almost Coach double Beck dribble. Wanted it, too.
Yep. He was right there in front of it. Oh.
Nice move inside there by Pontius.
Pontius is a good little player. He's 6'3", fairly tall. Right, take it.
Right idea, just a little slow getting it there. And a conversation, Coach Beck says that was tipped. If it's tipped and hits out up there, then that's...
Say it's our ball. I think Isaacson could have about 10 points now if he get to pick up the ball and get it up there.
He's bringing it down low, letting those shorter guys
start whopping
get their
at
hand
it.
On it.
Yep, and then he goes up and he can't shoot it far enough, or he just goes right back up.
So 21 on the shot clock. It's going to be Box Elder ball.
Nope, they're giving it to... So I guess it was tipped.
Kersey
nice
with
shot,
the tip
Kersey.
In.
Nice shot by Kersey.
Kersey gets, he can get up in the air.
Yeah, he can.
He is an athlete through and through.
Took that pass and jumped up and put it right in.
Nice turnaround there by Schuffenauer. Buchanan, corner three, short. Wilkinson the rebound.
He made it. Nice shot, Wilkinson. Good job. He's a tough little player.
Box Elder needed that. That's 4 points is all they've had here in this second quarter. Easy two there for Schuffenauer. It's a two-point game. Box Elder had a 9-point lead at the half, or the quarter.
Quarter.
Thank you. Mason gets fouled. First foul of the quarter. Belknap with his first foul.
Oh, Kersey, nice. Oh. Nice. Yeah, he did it.
Rebound by Isaacson and put back.
Oh.
Corner three, no good by Warren. And got his own shot back and
good follow.
Good follow for Wilkinson. That's out of bounds off from Isaacson. He just lowered his shoulder, went right into him. And
yeah, he did.
Isaacson just put his hands over and grabbed the ball, or tried to grab the ball.
He's lucky he didn't get a foul call line, but I'm glad they didn't call it.
I think that was a great no call on there. Yeah. I mean, contact was initiated by the offense. And
yeah, it was.
And
Mike
a block. Count the bucket. He's fouled. Fulcher the foul. So Isaacson to the crumble cookie free throw line again.
His first in third box on the number four, Caden Anderson.
Roy's coach having words with the official. In and out for Isaacson. Nice pass inside. Went Belknap to Pontius.
Good work by the Royals there.
Anderson,
no.
A little long. And Pontius, a little intimidated by, I think, by
good.
Isaacson. Out of bounds, off from Roy.
Boxer number 14, Ryan Jensen.
So Ryan Jensen, freshman in the game here for Box Elder. Inside, Isaacson. Count the
down
bucket,
down.
And he's fouled.
That's what we need. We need him to start scoring.
That's going to happen all day long. And then Isaacson again to the crumble cookie free throw line. That one goes on Pontius, his second. Pontius kind of defending his case to the official, but
there you
and
go.
That one's a good old-fashioned three-point play for Isaacson. Way downtown, Belknap, no good. Isaacson the rebound.
Take it. Oh, I want him to score.
I think that's one thing Mason needs to do is shoot more.
Yeah.
He lets so many of those go by.
That he can make. You watch him out here at warm-ups, he's always making them. You need him in the game making them.
Isaacson going to inbound this ball.
He's got his jersey.
Corner three, Isaacson, no good. Anderson the rebound.
Oh, take that.
They're discussing the clock. They decided everything's good. Box Elder ball on the side. Ten on the shot clock.
Oh, short.
And right there, Jansen saying, I got hit on the hand. I thought he did too. No shot clock right now. Playing for the last shot. Zone defense right here for Box Elder. That's going to be a foul before the shot on Mason. Out of bounds. That's Mason's second shot. For 6 seconds, Max will get a seat as well.
Okay. Don't let him shoot it now.
And short. No good. And at the half, they got it back to 9, 34 to 12. Okay, now they're going to call them back.
Yeah, he grabbed it, hit the ground with it, but why there's still, I think, 1 or 2 seconds left.
I thought it may have been out before, but I would have called it under a second.
Oh, and some call.
They're putting 0.7 on the clock. So it's got to be a catch and shoot.
Yep.
And they got 2 points out of it.
You believe that? Not supposed to do that.
No, you gotta play defense on an inbounds play.
Yeah,
so.
You do. Boy, that was Box Elder's sort of let up then.
Not sure what they've got going on here for halftime. Cheerleaders
Hi,
are
Sarah.
Getting in a circle in the corner of the court.
Come here. How are you doing?
Arthur, halftime entertainment. Let's welcome your Box Elder High School cheerleaders.
Thank you. All right, let's get ready real quick for the Crumble Cookie Halftime Show. That's going to come out right after a word from a couple of our sponsors. So stay tuned. We got our Crumble Cookie Halftime Show coming up right after this.
Investing in your education is an investment in yourself. Open doors with a degree from Utah State University and find your path to a more rewarding future. Reach your goals by attending USU Brigham City while staying close to home and saving money. Give yourself a chance to see the return. Your way, on campus, online. This is your U State.
Kent's Market is your hometown grocery store meeting your everyday needs. Whether it's fresh produce, quality meats, or a made-from-scratch bakery, their excellent customer service will meet your needs, even at their pharmacy. Kent's has stores located in Brigham City, Tremont, Roy, and Clearfield. Check us out on Facebook or on our website, www.kentsgrocery.com. Oh, and don't forget, every Friday, it's Fritter Friday. All fritters are 2 for $1. Kent's Market, locally owned and operated.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We do aftercare, and that's where Melanie Christie will go in and meet with a family after the services have been completed, and she'll help them with Social Security, help them file for life insurance, help them with federal government employee work. We go through credit cards. We help the family with all that transition that's coming out.
Nucor is a great company. They care about their people. They care about the environment.
I've never been restricted to fall in a box. I've never been told that I can't do something.
I saw it as a great opportunity to develop a career.
You create your own destiny at Nucor.
We're building something bigger out here at Nucor. Come join us.
All right, welcome to our Crumble Cookie Halftime Show here tonight. We have our cookies of the week. We got our chocolate-covered strawberry, the Valentine Original. Then we got a vanilla bean cupcake, milk chocolate chip, molten lava, and then the snickerdoodle. All right, tell us who we have here with us today.
I'm Clixie Hollingsworth.
All right.
And this is my daughter, Tana.
Tana Deem.
All right.
We shop at Crumble a lot.
A lot?
A lot.
Which one is your favorite?
Do I have to pick one? That's why I always choose six. I choose six and then I can have one of everything. Don't you think?
I'm Dulce de Leche. That's the one I like.
Yeah. All right. Pick your favorite one out of here and let us know what you think.
Okay.
Tried this one.
All right, that's all you get. What do you think of it?
All right, here we go. All right.
Really good.
Yeah, okay. So, all right, you better take another bite of that one.
Okay. I'll be on a sugar high. Okay.
That's what we want.
I know. That is delicious. Crumble cookies.
Good deal. Try another one. Pick another favorite. Molten lava. Is it as good as it looks?
Yes, definitely. Love the chocolate. Yeah.
I like how you take nice small bites so you can talk with your mouth full and it doesn't sound like it.
This one's a perfect one.
Perfect, huh?
Perfect, perfect. I don't even have to eat it, and I know this is going to be good.
You got to take a bite, though.
Okay.
Is it as perfect as it looked?
It's even better than this one.
Really?
It is.
Alrighty. Whoa. Snickerdoodle. How's our snickerdoodle?
It's good. Very good.
Which one is your favorite?
The cupcake.
Oh, vanilla bean cupcake.
Yeah.
Alright. Hey, we're going to get them all tried here. Chocolate covered strawberry.
That was the plan.
Alright. Okay, which one's your favorite?
I respect you, but not your friends.
Do I have to choose?
Crumble cookie. That's ours.
This one. Do I love crumble cookies?
All right. Good deal. Thank you very much for helping us out here tonight.
You guys are terrific.
Enjoy the rest of the game.
I'm going to go nibble.
All right.
is Sean Filson.
Paul Winterton.
Stephanie.
Haley.
Adam with the Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration.
Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
Our team is delivering the best care possible to patients that are suffering from osteoarthritis, degenerative joint disease, and also looking to optimize their sports performance.
I firmly believe that the body is designed to heal itself. So PRP, hyaluronic, those things are very safe and working with the body to heal.
Welcome to Joint Regeneration Center of Utah.
Earning your degree doesn't have to be complex. USU Brigham City lets you stay close to home and save money. As an Aggie, you'll have access to a personalized education with student support from faculty mentors. Let us help you achieve your goals your way. On campus, online, this is your U State.
The following was performed by everyday riders like you. Please try it home.
Matt's a straight ripper.
I heard the turbo and I was just giggling under my helmet.
Look at that.
I look like a pro.
Woohoo!
Dude, I love that thing.
All right, welcome back here. I had to try one of those crumble cookies. John's still eating his.
Ah, they're so good.
All right, so Box Elder up 8 coming here into the second half. We'll see how it turns out. Isaacson
Lincoln,
getting beat up in there, but
he's
just padding his rebound stats on that one. And Isaacson the foul on the other end. Pontius gets 2 and goes to the free throw line. And misses.
Oh,
rebound by Folger.
Out hustled this, so they're beating him up for it.
Timeout, Royals.
Timeout called.
Good defense by Box Elder. They could have taken that away from him.
We'll be right back.
We've been in business here at Gillis Funeral Chapel for the last 18 years. We purchased the mortuary, the funeral chapel, in 2001. My wife Lori and I have always felt that family is important, and when you have a family-owned funeral home, you get personal attention than you do than the big corporate funeral homes that are in the area. But we like to go one step further ahead.
All right, welcome back here. Roy attacking first here in the third quarter. Yeah. And Jepson with a foul.
Yeah, he was pushing him. Good defense.
Yeah, I won't disagree with the refs too bad on that.
No. Good hustle play, but he was pushing on him.
And that was Max Isaacson all the way with that one, and then a turnover on the other end. Blocked three-pointer. That block by Belknap. We have not had a three-pointer since the first quarter.
There was nothing in the second quarter?
Not a three-pointer.
And how many in the first? Six?
Five.
Five of them?
Downtown Belknap gets three.
Right back in the game again.
Kersey should have had the and one.
Yep. Changed hands with it.
He had Warren pushing him in the back all the way.
Oh, my heck.
Jepson with his second foul. This is going to get Folcher
three shots.
Doesn't get the first one. Doesn't get the second one.
You like that?
He makes one of three.
Oh,
Isaacson tried to tip it to Jepson. Jepson cut and wasn't there for the tip.
Yeah.
Turnover Box Elder, and it's a three-point game again. Rebound Jepson. Kersey.
Good.
Three-pointer. Count it. Another Brigham Community Pharmacy three-pointer.
Good shot.
Nice pass into Pontius. Foul on Belknap. That's Belknap's second foul, first team foul of the quarter for the Royals. Sumco comes back in.
Oh, come on.
That passing lane was kind of closed off there.
Yeah, it was like a door.
A little bit of happy feet there. They didn't call it on him. I wish they would have hit Kersey down there. Inside to Isaacson for two, and that's what they got to keep doing.
He's got to stay underneath there, but... He's missed so many shots. I know it's because they're hounding him and beating him up in there.
Oh. Nice shot in there by Belknap. Kersey out to Mason. Back to Kersey underneath. And a foul right there on Warren. Got his hand in, tangled up in the arms of Kersey and right in front of the official. Inside.
Oh.
Isaacson, a frustration foul on that one. Because I should have made that.
Yeah, he should have. No, but he was, I think he was afraid he was going to get hit. He was waiting for that somebody to hit him. They never did.
That's three on him. That's could be trouble down the road. Box Elder in his zone defense now. Folkjer, no good. Isaacson the rebound. Kersey downtown short. Drops right into Folkjer's hands. Not sure what happened to Schuffenauer there, but another Box Elder turnover. And a swat by Kersey.
Kersey, nice shot, Kersey. Nice block.
Count the bucket and he's fouled. Another foul on Warren. So Buchanan comes in, Anderson comes in, and Nesson will come in if Isaacson makes the free throw. Count the bucket. Probably a good move to sit Isaacson at this point,
yes,
right now with the
give him a rest.
Three fouls. You know, don't want to.
Don't even get that fourth one in the third quarter.
No. Let him sit for the last 3 minutes and then
see what he can do in the fourth quarter.
Nesson with the rebound after the Pontius miss. Inside,
nice
Anderson.
Oh, yeah. That's on us?
They're calling Anderson with the foul there.
Blocking foul, that guy ran him over.
And we got fans not letting the refs know they, their thoughts.
Yeah, they didn't like that call. Get out of there.
It would have been out if the backboard wasn't there.
Yeah. Could have kept on rolling.
Two for two for Belknap. Ooh, foul on Pontius. Clothesline.
That's got
Buchanan.
Three on him now. Yeah, that's three on Pontius. There was no travel. I didn't quite see a travel in there.
I wasn't watching his feet, but I know there's a lot of hands on the ball.
Yeah.
Bees with a 7-point lead. Procher with two.
Oh, my heck.
Another
come on, Box Elder. Let's
turnover.
Take your times.
Procher for three. And he's got it. And it's back to a 2-point game.
Let's get those guys back in there.
And another turnover.
That's two for him right away.
Anderson's. Frocher wants three again, doesn't take it. Nelson, no good. Buchanan, the rebound. Ten-second difference between the shot and the game clock.
Kersey never quits. He's always after that thing.
Seven to go.
No.
Wide open three
for
Nelson. All right. Box Elder's lead is wiped away. They're down one.
Going into the last quarter.
Going into the fourth quarter. We'll be back right after this.
Kent's Market is your hometown grocery store meeting your everyday needs. Whether it's fresh produce, quality meats, or a made-from-scratch bakery, their excellent customer service will meet your needs, even at their pharmacy. Kent's has stores located in Brigham City, Tremont, Roy, and Clearfield. Check us out on Facebook or on our website, www.kentsgrocery.com. Oh, and don't forget, every Friday, it's Fritter Friday. All fritters are two for $1. Kent's Market, locally owned and operated.
Investing in your education is an investment in yourself. Open doors with a degree from Utah State University and find your path to a more rewarding future. Reach your goals by attending USU Brigham City while staying close to home and saving money. Give yourself a chance to see the return. Your way, on campus, online. This is your U State.
Nucor is a great company. They care about their people. They care about the environment.
I've never been restricted to fall in a box. I've never been told that I can't do something.
I saw it as a great opportunity to develop a career.
You create your own destiny.
We're building something bigger out here at Nucor. Come join us.
All right, welcome back.
Okay, this is it, last quarter. Box Elder down one.
Roy had the best quarter of the night in that third quarter. They had 22 points in the third quarter. Box Elder had 21 in the first. Box Elder won the first quarter, and Roy has won both the second and third quarters. So Box Elder's got to buckle down and play. Box Elder had 5 3-pointers in the first quarter, none in the second, and one in the third.
So they need to get a couple here. They need to play some good defense. And I mean, they've had the shots, not another one.
Nelson again. That's 2 3-pointers back to back for Nelson. Inside, Isaacson.
There you go.
2 points all day long if they'd just do that.
Just get it to that guy and let him pitch it.
I was talking to Coach Beck. He says, you know, he says sometimes it's not, they don't do what they're supposed to do, and they just get whatever ends up. Isaacson picks up the steal and a foul on Belknap. Coach Beck wanting an intentional foul. The officials are discussing. Intentional foul is the call on Belknap. Belknap trying to plead his case. The call has been made. I don't think he's going to change their mind. So we've got Isaacson at the Crumble Cookie free throw line. Chance to tie it back up.
He shoots two, then we get the ball back.
And we get the ball back. And he's made it. It's a tie ball game. Thanks to Crumble Cookies and their awesome cookies that they have.
Yes, they are.
Officials conversing about something. Not sure what they're talking about, but. Nesson with the foul.
Who ran over him?
Nesson did, apparently.
Nesson called him a name, I think. He's complaining.
Missed shot, Kersey the rebound. And a bad pass into the hands of Frochter, and all tied up. And
oh,
into the hands of
right out.
That was great defense.
Boy,
there
it was.
And then turn around and give it right back to him.
They were both good plays.
Except for the one we shouldn't have passed.
Yeah. Oh, nice hit.
Kersey. Technical foul right there on Schuffenhauer.
What did he do? I think
he said something. I think he was taunting on there. Wilkinson to the free throw line. Makes the first.
He said he hit the ball. That's not what they were worried
about. They didn't call the foul.
No.
He just turned around and, you know, taunted him a little bit, and they didn't put up with that.
No, they won't go. They won't go. Yeah, this ref right there, that call.
And now the coaches are getting at it. And Bucks other players are trying to get Coach Beck to stay back, and so little excitement going on here.
He said something underneath there that the ref didn't like.
And we have the reigning issue to the benches.
So both benches got an official warning on that. So I think what they ended up going back and calling was that play was a jump ball. I don't know.
He said
Buck Elder ball.
After he knocked him the ball, he said something, and I think that's what the original thing was he was taunting him. That's what it looked like. Shoot it.
Nelson from the corner again, no good. And there's going to be a foul right there on Pontius as he overreacts on a box out and levels Buchanan. Four on Pontius. This game's getting exciting.
Yeah, it is.
And refs have been good keeping it under control. I just hope they keep it there.
Yep. The Box Elder is getting a little touchy, or Roy is.
Kersey, he nice takes shot, it in Kersey. For two. I would not want to get in the way of that.
No.
B's up by four now. Coach Beck wanting the student section to get involved in this game at this point.
Ooh.
They're calling a foul on Buchanan.
Everybody that gets a foul called on him now, they don't think they fouled. That young umpire will not take no ref, won't take any crap from anybody.
That's good. Belknap at the free throw line.
He's doing a dang good job out there.
And he rolls the other one in. Timeout called. We'll take one as well, and we will be right back.
Earning your degree doesn't have to be complex. USU Brigham City lets you stay close to home and save money. As an Aggie, you'll have access to a personalized education with student support from faculty mentors. Let us help you achieve your goals your way. On campus, online, this is your U State.
Hi, I'm Ryan from CoverUp. We offer embroidery and screen printing to help you promote your business. We can also help you with your church or school groups, family reunions, or any other occasion that might require a t-shirt. So come in and see us at 47 South Main in Brigham City or 115 West Main in Tremonton.
All right, welcome back. We are getting close. Just under four and a half minutes left to go here in the game. Both teams out there have been fired up.
Yeah, they're ready. They're ready for the last 4.5 minutes. They're excited and ready to get this going.
Yep.
Tempers are flaring a little bit.
Just a little.
And they just got to watch it.
Oh, man. Foul on Isaacson. That's almost as much Kersey's fault. He did not take his player into that screen. If he would have come off from that screen a little closer, I don't think that would have been a foul.
It probably wouldn't have been. Oh, don't go in. Ooh.
They're saying that's on the ground.
Did they?
Foul on Mason.
Foul strikes to number two, Jordan Mason, his third.
Jepson will come back in.
And for box L, number 33, Mason Jepson.
Isaacson is going to sit for just a second, I bet. I don't think they keep him out very long.
No, not this much time left. Oh.
Kersey with the foul on that one.
Yeah.
You can't.
He was up there and he just couldn't do nothing.
That's his third.
I thought it was fourth.
No, that's only three. He made it through the entire second, third quarters without one. In and out, Fulcher misses. That was a great move by Fulcher on his part because, the pump fake, and he got one out of it anyway.
Yep, he had Kersey right up in the air again.
Timeout called. Box Elder. We'll be right back.
My name is John Filson.
Paul Winterton.
Stephanie Haley.
Adam with the Joint Regeneration.
Joint
Regeneration Center of Utah.
Our team is delivering the best care possible to patients that are suffering from osteoarthritis, degenerative joint disease, and also looking to optimize their sports performance.
I firmly believe that the body is designed to heal itself. So PRP, hyaluronic, those things are very safe and working with the body to heal.
Welcome to Joint Regeneration Center.
Kent's Market is your hometown grocery store, meeting your everyday needs. Whether it's fresh produce, quality meats, or a made-from-scratch bakery, their excellent customer service will meet your needs, even at their pharmacy. Kent's has stores located in Brigham City, Tremont, Roy, and Clearfield. Check us out on Facebook or on our website, www.kentsgrocery.com. Oh, and don't forget, every Friday, it's Fritter Friday. All fritters are 2 for $1. Kent's Market, locally owned and operated.
All right, welcome back. Hit the right buttons here, things might work.
I want to miss the last 3 minutes.
Zone defense here by Roy.
There.
Mason for three. In and out.
I'm glad he shot it, even if he didn't make it. Gives him a little bit of confidence. That was close.
I wish he would shoot a few
more. Oh, I do. He's open a few times that he can.
Inside to Pontius for two.
What happened?
Block. It was a steal. And then Jepson with the block. Inside, Jepson,
yeah.
2 points. Nice pass from Kersey.
Up by Jepson. Got to keep your eye on Hershey. He's pretty good. You don't know if he's going to shoot it or pass it when he comes through there.
Fulcher downtown, no good. Kersey the rebound.
Rebound.
30-second timeout. We'll take a quick one and be right back.
Hi, I'm Ryan from CoverUp. We offer embroidery and screen printing to help you promote your business. We can also help you with your church or school groups, family reunions, or any other occasion that might require a t-shirt. So come in and see us at 47 South Main in Brigham City or 115 West Main in Tremonton.
I think that timeout, I think the only reason why they took it is Kersey's shoe came untied. He was trying to tie it, and coach just didn't want anything to happen in there. Smart timeout. Again. 22 seconds left on the shot clock. Back to man-to-man defense here for Roy. Kersey takes it up. And they're calling a foul. I don't know about that, but they're calling it on Wilkinson. At least it's on Wilkinson and not Isaacson. That's his first.
I thought they called it on Isaacson.
Fulcher, the free throw line, makes the first. He's missed a few. And makes the second. Coming in clutch, he's making them.
Yep. This is the same way it was with Roy last week, I guess. Marcel's got to pull it out here.
Oh, Kersey in and out. Rebound goes to Belknap. A bump foul.
That was
a little
bad
tiny
one.
Bump.
Yeah, that wasn't a. That wasn't a good foul.
Coach Beck wanted a call on the other end if they're going to do that, and I can't say I blame him.
Really?
That should have been a lane violation. I thought he stepped across that line before it went in.
He was looked like he was down there, but I didn't see where his feet was.
And we got some blood, so he's got to get it cleaned off.
Just wipe it off, kid. That's all you got to do. Make everybody happy. Don't complain about it. Just wipe it off, and now we can go. Good job. Here you go.
And he made the second one.
We're down three. Come on,
I think he just had words again with Mason.
Good.
Three-pointer. Timeout called. It's tied up. We got 37.9 left in the game.
It's tied up. Roy's got the ball, so we'll get the ball back.
We will definitely have the ball back. 25 on the shot clock. So, nail biter.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, John, I want to see you do what the cheerleaders are doing down there.
They're just standing there.
No, they jumped and turned a circle in the air.
I'd jump, and if I tried to turn, I'd break every bone in my back.
No, Box Elder, they got to play good defense right here. They can't afford to foul. Any foul right here is going to give them two free throws.
Yep.
On the other hand, Roy, they've got a foul to give.
Yeah, they got one to give.
So, you know, Wilkins has got a hot hand. You know, at this point, you're going to offensively going to want the ball in the hands of either Kersey, Wilkinson, or Isaacson.
Yeah, that Wilkinson's still a little bit hot, too. Hey, I you go to either one of those three. I wish that number two, Mason, could have got into there and started shooting.
.25 on the shot clock. Quick shot, and it goes in. Advantage right now goes to Roy. Kersey misses, gets fouled. He's going to go to the line and shoot two. Schuffenhauer, the foul. Kersey right here with a chance to tie it. Makes the first one from the Crumble Cookie free throw line. Timeout called by Roy with 19.2 left.
Coming down the end here.
What's the call?
Kersey's got to make it.
Kersey's got to make it, and they got 19.2 left.
Yep. And then I think they're going to go to Belknap. He's been their hot guy. He's been the one that's sort of taking control out there.
I think the primary reason for this is trying to ice Kersey. I don't think it'll happen.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think it will either.
But Roy's got to try for the last second shot. This could, if they make it, this is my prediction. Kersey makes a free throw. Roy goes for the last second shot. If they miss it, it's overtime.
They make it, they win.
If they make it, they win.
Yeah, it all depends on what Kersey does here with this ball.
Yep.
He's got to make it. That's all there is to it.
If he misses, it's got to be a really quick foul on Box Elder's part.
Yep.
Okay, he made it. Ball's in the hands of Belknap. Almost threw it away. Pulls it up, shot, it's good. Timeout. That should have 2.3 on the clock at least.
See, Belknap was the one that was going to go to. Yeah, that's where
he
was going.
You called it, John.
That's where they were going to was Belknap.
I saw at least 2.3 after I looked up after the shot went in. So it should have been closer to 3 seconds thereabouts. Because... I looked up after, not after he made it, but after Coach Beck was out there calling timeout.
And it was 2.3?
That's what I thought, but.
Well, they're leaving it as it is.
See, somebody else is yelling 2.3, too.
So we at the table here thinks it should be 2.3 seconds left, which would give Boxelder a better chance. But I don't know, the speed they got, they might be able to be okay here.
Okay, you're going to want the ball in the hands of Kersey or Wilkinson from this far down. My guess is, yep.
They knocked it out. There's some time left. There should be three seconds left. No, I'm bailing out. You made the last shot. We got a shot. Yeah, point three.
Well, they need to let the scorers tell them know how much time. Point three, is they got to catch and shoot, all they can do.
Yep.
They're just going to lob it up to Isaacson, I think.
Yep. Not far enough.
Make it.
Oh, wow.
So, final score, Boxelder 63, Roy 65. That was a nail biter.
That was, right down to the very end. Very good game.
I mean, they had a shot to tie it there at the end.
He almost made it. I thought Will Isaacson was going to take it. But Kersey had a good shot on it.
So Boxelder won the first quarter. Roy won the second, third, and fourth quarters.
Yeah, they did.
So, I mean,
heck of a ball game, though.
Yeah, it was close all the way through. Again, we don't know how the boys are kind of on the fence whether or not they're going to get a home playoff game or not.
I hope so. I'd like to come to one more.
That would be nice. But we will probably see, and I think they come out tomorrow on that, if I remember correctly. Good luck to Roy in the state tournament, and hopefully we'll see what Boxelder ends up doing here with the rest of their season as well. But no, a great game, fun to watch.
Fun game to watch.
You know, I'd much rather have a fun game than a blowout either way around. So.
Yeah, it's fun to watch them like this.
So, John, thanks for helping me out. Please,
you bet.
Rewatch the game. It's always a fun game. And please stop by and thank our sponsors. We've got Brigham City Outdoors. We've had lots of new snow. Great place to go get your skis, rent your skis, take them up on the hill. They also do season rentals up there as well if you want to rent skis for just the whole season. And, Brigham Heating and Cooling, is almost time to turn on the air conditioner.
It's getting close.
You know, they'll take your reservation, though, if you call them. You know, you get it scheduled. It's about that time. Also, the rest of our sponsors, please stop by. Let them know that you saw their ad here on BI Sports Media. They appreciate that, knowing that their money is well spent. The people are seeing their advertising. So
yeah, which they love to see. So
all right, stay tuned to our Facebook page. We will let you know where or when and who and all that other good stuff as far as what's going to happen here in the postseason, but that'll do it for the regular season for us. And appreciate everybody watching. And again, thanks, John, for joining me.
Yeah, fun being here the last game.
All right.
It felt good to be back.